It's fantastic to have you here with us this morning. Are you looking forward to the film?
I am really looking forward to it, yes.
Are you a big fan of the Ice Age film?
Yeah, Ice Age, anything that's animated, I really like them.
Ice Age, one of those things, it's been around for over 10 years, it's loved around the world. Why do you think particularly this animated franchise is just so universally adored?
I think it's because it's slightly educational. Like, when you look at all the different ones, like global warming and all that sort of stuff, I think it makes it educational. So the kids are sort of learning, but at the same time, it's fun.
When you were a little kid, little Mario, did you have a particular favourite animated film? Is there one that stuck with you?
I can't remember, so obviously not.
Probably not then.
I was a big like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles fan, and that's all I remember.
How do you feel about the fact they're bringing back the Ninja Turtles, apparently?
That's the first I heard of. I'm very excited now.
I think Michael Bay and a couple of other people.
It's the best news I've heard today.
Who's your favourite turtle?
Leonardo.
Why Leonardo? Because I always think your choice of Ninja Turtle says a lot about who you are inside.
Yeah, I don't know. I used to draw them all the time as well. It was really weird. I wasn't cool as a kid.
You're pretty cool now. I have to ask, how has being involved in the show changed your life?
It is something else. Literally, they warn you before you go on the screen that your life will change. But it is something else. You get recognised everywhere you go. But I still try and keep normal. I still go to work every day. I still do a 9 to 5, so I try and not let it change my life.
Obviously, you know, you're trying to keep a normal life going, but it must be quite difficult, I'd imagine, with kind of the fans constantly coming up to you, people recognising you all the time. Have you had any especially interesting fan encounters?
I've had knickers thrown at me. I've had...
Who by?
Just girls when I've been on the PAs. Girls. Yeah, I had a group of 3 girls start doing the splits in front of me and stuff. Been jumped on. Weird stuff, really.
Who jumped on you, and did you enjoy it?
I didn't enjoy it, no.
It was unwelcome. It was unrequested.
I just walked into a club, and it was ridiculous. Funny, though, but yeah.
I mean, I guess in relationship terms as well, that must make it quite difficult to have a normal dating life if you've got, you know, people just throwing themselves at you left, right and centre.
Yeah, it is, but at the same time, I mean, you know... I'm a big boy, so if anyone ever, you know, tries to jump, it's quite easy to push them off and stuff. You know, I know where I am, I know where I want to be, I know that I'm with Lucy, so, you know, it doesn't really matter.
There's obviously been such a massive kind of wave of reality TV shows that have kind of followed the same format as TOWIE. What do you think it is, though, that makes your shows distinct and has just propelled it to the top of that pile?
I think it's because people can relate to it. I mean, when you've got Made in Chelsea, don't get me wrong, it's a good programme, but... It's focused on a niche market, it's focused on rich people, so only rich people can really get it. And I mean, with Geordie Shore, it's a good, fun programme, but at the same time, it can't be viewed by kids. So whereas with TOWIE, it's sort of like, it's family-based, but it can apply to all audiences, so literally everyone can watch it, everyone can relate to it. That's why the viewers are so high.
What do you think TOWIE's done for the perception of Essex? How do you think it's changed that?
I think people's perception of Essex has always been a bit... Not negative, but towards that sort of line. And I think, I'm not sure the show's helped that, but I think when people actually meet us on a one-to-one, they actually see that we're not thick from Essex. We all are, some of us are intellectual, you know. You've got to think as well, everyone's making the most of the opportunity. They've all got their own businesses and stuff now, so I think, I don't know. I've been to a lot of places in this country, and trust me, Essex is up there.
I mean, talking long-term, I mean, obviously a lot of people have stepped on from the show to other things, you know, I mean... Mark's off doing his thing. I mean, do you have those kinds of ambitions? It sounds like you kind of just want a normal life, really.
I do and I don't. I mean, you know, I think it's hard to say where I'm going to be in a year because a year ago I was in London tailoring. So, and now I'm on the biggest reality TV show in this country. So you can't really say where you're going to go. It depends on opportunities arise. But I don't know. I've got a few things up my sleeve, but I'm not saying anything.
Keeping them under the sleeve for now. Well, final question. Do you have a message for TOWIE fans? Anything you'd like to say to them before you leave us?
We love you all, and yeah, tune in for series 6 on July the 22nd.
I mean, season 6, I mean, obviously, fans will be waiting anxiously to get their next fix. What can they expect, I mean, compared to the previous season?
No, because, like, compared to the other shows, like Geordie Shore and Made in Chelsea, they film it months and months in advance, so they know what's happened. Whereas we film on a 3-day cycle, so whatever you're watching is happening in our lives at that current time, so we never know. Anything could happen. That's what I think makes it so interesting.